Magandang araw mga kapamilya. Today is Saturday of the 7th week of Easter. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. The disciples devoted themselves with one accord to prayer with the women and Mary, the mother of Jesus, and his brethren. Alleluia.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that we who have celebrated the Paschal festivities may by your gift hold fast to them in the way we live our lives. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
First reading, a reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When he entered Rome, Paul was allowed to live by himself with a soldier who was guarding him. 3 days later, he called together the leaders of the Jews. When they had gathered, he said to them, "My brothers, although I have done nothing against our people or our ancestral customs, I was handed over to the Romans as a prisoner from Jerusalem. After trying my case, the Romans wanted to release me because they found nothing against me deserving the death penalty. But when the Jews objected, I was obliged to appeal to Caesar, even though I had no accusation to make against my own nation. This is the reason, then, I have requested to see you and to speak with you. For it is on account of the hope of Israel that I wear these chains." He remained for 2 full years in his lodgings. He received all who came to him, and with complete assurance and without hindrance, he proclaimed the kingdom of God and taught about the Lord Jesus Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. The just will gaze on your face, O Lord.
The just will gaze on your face, O Lord.
The Lord is in his holy temple. The Lord's throne is in heaven. His eyes behold, his searching glance is on mankind.
The just will gaze on your face, O Lord.
The Lord searches the just and the wicked. The lover of violence he hates. For the Lord is just. He loves just deeds. The upright shall see his face.
The just will gaze on your face, O Lord. Alleluia, alleluia. I will send to you the Spirit of truth, says the Lord. He will guide you to all truth. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Peter turned and saw the disciple following whom Jesus loved, the one who had also reclined upon his chest during the supper and had said, "Master, who is the one who will betray you?" When Peter saw him, he said to Jesus, "Lord, what about him?" Jesus said to him, "What if I want him to remain until I come? What concern is it of yours? You follow me." So the word spread among the brothers that the disciple would not die. But Jesus had not told him that he would not die. Just, "What if I want him to remain until I come? What concern is it of yours?" It is this disciple who testifies to these things and has written them, and we know that his testimony is true. There are also many other things that Jesus did, but if these were to be described individually, I do not think the whole world would contain the books that would be written. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Ngayon ho ay ang huling araw ng Easter, no? Kasi bukas Pentecost na, bahagi pa siya ng celebration natin. Pero bukas ho ay Pentecost Sunday na. At pagdating ng Lunes ay balik na tayo sa ordinary time. So in a sense, this is the kumbaga, this is the closing story for the Easter season that we have celebrated the last 7 weeks, no? And napakaganda ng ending kasi ito rin ho ang katapusan ng Ebanghelyo ni San Juan. Kung saan tayo nagbasa ng halos siguro for mga 5 weeks, I think yung Ebanghelyo ng ating mga misa pang araw-araw ay nanggagaling sa the Gospel of John. At karamihan din ng mga Sunday Masses, we read from the Gospel of St. John. Nais ko lang ho ipakita, kagaya ng sinabi ko kahapon, ang Ebanghelyo, huling bahagi ng Ebanghelyo ni San Juan, ay nagpapakita sa atin ng ano ang kahulugan ng pagiging follower of Christ. Diba kahapon sinabi niya kay Peter, yung pantapos ng Ebanghelyo, follow me. At ngayon, meron na naman isang sinabi ang Panginoon, di ba ho, na nung paalis na sila, sabi ni San Pedro, kagaya ng narinig natin sa Ebanghelyo, referring to St. John the Beloved, John the Evangelist, what about the beloved disciple, John? Anong papano siya? And the Lord tells Peter, no, your business is to follow me, don't worry about him. No? Siguro yun yung unang punto ho ng following of Christ, no? Na kailangan focus. Na kailangan, ultimately ho kasi, the following of Christ is a personal relationship that you cannot compare to the relationship of other people. Hindi ho tayo dapat maghambing sapagkat ang mission ko ho ay iba sa mission ninyo. And that is because of our personal relationship with Christ. Diba ho, narinig niyo yung sinasabi ko nitong mga nakaraan linggo sa misa natin, there is no generic mission. Walang generic na mission. Lahat ng mission ay always a personal mission nang gagaling sa Panginoon, nang gagaling sa Diyos. And the reason why it is personal ay dahil ho ang ating relationship sa Panginoon ay personal. Hindi rin generic ang relationship natin sa Panginoon. So that first focus of following of Christ because it is a personal relationship. And then the other beautiful thing about this gospel passage is that in a sense, it gives us two ways of doing mission or living out mission or following Christ. Kung natatandaan niyo, 'di ba, noong Lent, 'di ba, bago mag Holy Week, merong tayong mga ebanghelyo na binasa tungkol kay Martha at kay Mary. 'Di ba? Si Martha yung lagi nagtatrabaho, si Mary naman yung nagdadasal, 'di ba? Always reflecting and praying while Martha was the active, no? The active element. Here you have the same, basically the same, no? That among the 12 apostles, you have the figure of Peter and the figure of John. Remember, si John po ay ang the only disciple apostle who did not die a martyr's death, no? Who did not die early. In fact, di ba supposedly, he died at old age. Kasi sabi nga, di ba, sa tradisyon naman, kaya daw siya mahaba ang buhay kasi siya nag-alaga sa mahal na birhen. Kaya daw lahat ng devotee ng mahal na birhen, mahaba ang buhay. Pero ang dito ho, pinapakita sa atin, Peter was the shepherd, the active evangelist. In fact, di ba, sabi nga nila, di ba, that the church was founded on the apostolate of Peter and Paul, the two great evangelizers of the church. No? That Peter was the active evangelist. And then, John is more di ba, siya yung nagsulat, siya yung nagkwento, he became witness through the stories that he told. And again, no, that old age na hindi siya lumabas para mag-evangelize, pero dahil sa kanyang testimony at sa witnessing, naging mahalagang bahagi ho yan ng paglago ng simbahan at paglago ng pananampalataya. So to begin to see that there are many ways, di ba? Sabi nga nila, di ba, nung tatanda ko nung araw sinasabi sa amin, one faith, many theologies. So ganito rin, no? One faith, many spiritualities and the way to serve God. One mission, but several ways to serve the mission. And yun ho siguro ang magandang pagtatapos ng ating pagninilay ngayong Easter, no? Makita natin na in the end, everything is centered on following Christ in a personal way. And there are different ways to live out mission. So let me end our Easter reflections as we go into Pentecost tomorrow by leaving behind again one of the themes that we prayed over during this Easter season and during the Lenten season. That as we go back to ordinary time, as we go to the day-to-day moments of our life, I ask you again to remember that prayer that in these day-to-day moments, the ordinary moments in our life, that we may see Christ more clearly, love Him more dearly, and follow Him more nearly. Let us pray that this will continue to be a grace that will grow in us as we enter ordinary time next week. And let us pray tomorrow to the Holy Spirit that we may be given this grace of prayer, of contemplation, and of action. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And together now, let us offer our prayer for ABS-CBN's franchise renewal. And let us pray also for our congressmen, our senators, and all government leaders who will eventually deliberate and decide on this renewal.
Loving Father, our risen Lord and most Holy Spirit, you guide all the affairs of men and women of goodwill. We thank you for the gift of mission to ABS-CBN to be in the service of the Filipino. We thank you for blessing ABS-CBN's work, most especially with the millions of Filipinos and friends who are one with ABS-CBN in its mission. We in ABS-CBN pray that with grateful hearts we will strive to be better, improving on what we do best and correcting our failures and shortcomings. We turn to you now, one in prayer, faith, and hope, in ABS-CBN's need, humbly asking that you send your Spirit to guide all our leaders in the executive and judicial branches of government, and most especially our congressmen and senators, that they may conduct a fair and truthful hearing and come to a decision that is for the greater good of the greater majority of the Filipino people and of our world. We ask this through the intercession of Our Lady of Fatima, and in the name of Jesus Christ, our risen Lord. Amen.
And again, we continue to pray for all our frontliners, for all those who are suffering because of this crisis, especially the families whose members are daily wage earners. Let's also pray for all the sick, especially those afflicted by the virus, and for all those who lost loved ones because of this virus. So we pray for all of those working every day to provide us with basic services. So let us remember them as we continue our Mass. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, to your goodness. We have this bread to offer, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us our spiritual food.
Blessed be God forever.
By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, to your goodness we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, they will become for us our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
May the Holy Spirit, coming near, we pray, O Lord, prepare our minds for the divine sacrament, since the Spirit Himself is the remission of all sins, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For after His resurrection, He plainly appeared to all His disciples, and was taken up to heaven in their sight, that He might make us sharers in His divinity. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. We remember especially those who died because of this virus. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us now, with confidence in God as our Father, turn to him and offer to him the prayer that our Lord Jesus taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin and protect us from all anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "I leave you peace, my peace I give you." Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And together let us pray the Oratio Imperata.
God our Father, we come to you in our need to ask your protection against the COVID-19 that has disturbed and even claimed lives. We pray that you guide a people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. Protect the medical experts that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health soon. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Grant us the grace in this trying time to work for the good of all and to help those in need. We ask for your special providence and protection for the whole world and humanity, our country and our people, our families and our friends. Send your spirit to protect us from this virus. We implore you to stop the spread of this virus and to save us from our fears. Grant all these through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and ever-blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
Saint Roch.
Pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu.
Have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy.
Have mercy on us.
And let us pray. Hear in your compassion our prayers, O Lord, that as we have been brought from things of the past to new mysteries, so with former ways left behind, we may be made new in holiness of mind and heart through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Again, ano ho, ngayon at bukas ang dalawang huling araw ng Mayo, the month of Our Lady. So we pray that you will continue to pray the rosary as a family, and not just during May, but hopefully every day, no? Especially as we rebuild and we create the new heaven and the new earth in our country and in the world. And also, tomorrow is Pentecost Sunday, so this afternoon ho, meron tayong anticipated mass na for Pentecost Sunday. And then also, please watch Journeys of Hope. We have Charo Santos Concho this weekend. After every Kapamilya Sunday Mass, sumusunod yung Journeys of Hope. And it's available also in iWant, in TFC, and also starting 11 a.m. on Sunday in the ABS-CBN YouTube channel, My Prayer Channel. So join us in My Journeys of Hope. And again, we ask for your continued prayers for ABS-CBN and to join us every 12 noon on Saturdays, this Saturday, for the Angelus, for these intentions, for the world, the Church, the Pope, and our country. Our Mass is ended. Let us go in the joy of the risen Lord.
Thanks be to God.